Well, a lot of ghost fishing relies on very, very good dive skills and a strong dependence on teamwork as well. Most people have decent dive skills and most people can work in a team, but they all do it different ways. So really, our training course was really to bring everybody onto the same page as the way we do it in Ghost Fishing UK.
And then we're going to shoot the marker buoy. Okay, only one marker buoy. Team comes up.
We reversed engineered it at the end of the day to look at what we needed our divers to be able to do. And that came from a lot of experience that we had in Scapa Flow and on the South Coast as well. So we looked at the kind of skills that a normal diver has, and we just basically filled in the gaps in the middle. So the course is going to be broken into three chunks, really, if you like. The in-water chunks comprise basically some refinement and some polish of basic skills, a clean-up of equipment to make sure it's all nice and streamlined. Then we're going to look at the survey techniques, how you go about working out what animals are living on the ghost gear, how you assess the ghost gear to make a good plan to remove it. And the final phase of the in-water work is how you actually go about lifting it, the teamwork that's involved in that, special tools that we use like lifting bags, and how we recover that stuff to the surface nice and safely. The other aspect that we need to cover is some theoretical work, and there's a little bit of basic dive review theory. There's a component on the legal side of ghost fishing, which is very important. Not many people understand how much work goes on in the background to make sure that the work that we do is legal and above board. Well, another aspect that we're always really keen to cover is the survey side of things in regard to the marine life that's on these ghost nets. Now, the whole purpose of removing these ghost nets is to protect wildlife. So it makes no sense if we don't actually know what it is that we're looking at. It's critically important that we know what marine life is on the ghost gear that we recover. If we don't know that, then how do we know we're doing any good, basically? So we've cooperated with Jo Porter at Heriot Watt University. She's been hugely helpful in telling us what species are important to record. We've also recently started working with Charlotte Bolton at Sea Search. Well, Fobster may seem like a funny choice for a ghost fishing course, and I was a little bit skeptical at the start as well, I have to say. But what it does give us is a controlled environment. It gives us sheltered water, shallow water, it gives us all the logistics that we need on site. So Fobster Key have been very, very supportive. They've allowed us to put fishing gear into their lake. They've basically let us use the boat to go over and drop onto the ghost gear that we put in place, and generally been super supportive of the project. So I'd like to thank Fobster for all the support they've given us.
This is a demonstration of suction in sedimenty mud.
You at Elstree, come round, I'll show you suction.
I promise.
I'm not very wrong!
I think it depends on the viscosity and the specific gravity of the mud.
So thanks to Fobster Key for the support. Where it's your mate, that is.
Oh no,
I don't know. Probably.